Hello again. I hope everything is going well for you. Are you ready to try out a fun blue look? I am so stoked that it turned out as well as it did. I wasn't really sure how it was going to go. So the two fat palettes that I'm focusing on, of course, Too Faced Chocolate Bar palette as per usual, and Lorac Pro 2. I'm so, I cannot wait to delve into this palette again. So if you're looking for colors that I'm using out of the Chocolate Bar palette, I focused, of course, on white chocolate, salted caramel, creme brulee, champagne truffle, semi-sweet, and triple fudge. Except I'm not using triple fudge on camera because I went on and did my eyebrows before I came on to film. And then as far as the Lorac Pro 2 palette, really the only shade I used out of here is navy. But if you're not using the Too Faced Chocolate Bar palette, you can also sub in light brown in place of salted caramel. It will give you a very similar effect. So, oh, I'm so excited about this. And then additionally, I did pick up the Wet n Wild Pro Line Graphic Marker Eyeliner in the shade Airliner Blue. This is my first time to use it on at all, in addition to being on camera. So I do like this for the most part, but first impression wise, it is kind of a little bit messy, as you'll see in just a few minutes as we apply the makeup. And also, I definitely wanted to make sure that I included usage of my Bare Minerals pigments that I've chosen to pan for the Justice League panning challenge. So today I'm focusing on the color I chose for the Flash, Aquaman, and Superman. So let's go on and get into it. If you're looking to recreate this look at home, have fun, have fun, have fun. It is so much like summery color, because even though it's like dark navy blue, it's actually quite wearable in person. So you can always intensify it if you're going out at night, or if you want something that's going to be very specific for an outfit or things like that. So to start off, all right, as we get into this look, the easiest thing to do is go along with your favorite eyeshadow primer out of your collection. I am using the Lorac Behind the Scenes Eye Primer, and then I'm going in with my favorite fluffy concealer brush from e.l.f., and I'm setting it with the shade Too Faced shade White Chocolate from the Chocolate Bar palette. Feel free to use any cream shadow out of your collection, or if you have a deeper skin tone, something that you feel comfortable with that will give you a blank canvas on your skin to make these deeper shadows a whole lot easier to blend. You don't have to have a lot of precision with it. Just go over with that fluffy brush to diffuse the color enough. And then as we go into the next step, since I have hooded lids, I definitely want to make sure that I have a bright shimmery color that will not crease, won't transfer during the day. And so I'm going through with the Julep Eyeshadow 101 cream shadow stick in the shade Pearl Shimmer, just to not only make my eyeshadow bulletproof during the day, but this also helps lighten up creme brulee just a touch, so it's closer to the color light bronze from the Lorac Pro palette. I found that of all the pans of gold that I have used and finished off, light bronze has been the most flattering for me. And so this helps lighten it just enough where it's very, very similar. But if you're using the Lorac Pro palette, light bronze is great. Or if you're jumping in with Urban Decay's Half Baked or your favorite gold from another brand or whatnot, again, if you go in with a cream shadow base, it will help lighten it up just enough. So I can't recommend enough the Maybelline Color Tattoo concentrated crayons, or if you have the Maybelline Color Tattoos in the pots, or the MAC paint pots. I think Rubenesque might make it too rose gold. I'm trying to think of what the gold shade or the beigey shimmery cream shade is in that. I don't own it because all I have is soft ochre, but MAC also makes like a shimmery champagne that has the slightest bit of glimmer to it. So go through with whatever you want. And then as far as my lid shade, I'm going through with creme brulee from my Too Faced Chocolate Bar palette and my e.l.f. flat C brush. It makes it the easiest to stamp onto my lid because I don't want a lot of fallout all over my cheeks. Sometimes it happens because the shades can get kind of powdery, but the e.l.f. C brush you can get for $6 at Target. It is one of my absolute most favorite brushes of all time. So just go on and pack it all over the lid, you are good to go. Then in terms of transition, let's go with something really, really easy, warm brown. Easy to find through all of your collection. I reached for salted caramel out of the Too Faced Chocolate Bar palette, but if you're not panning it, you can also go in with light brown from your Lorac Pro 2 palette, or your favorite warm brown if you're using something from MAC or something from Makeup Geek or something from Anastasia Beverly Hills or any one of your favorite neutrally like warm brown shadows. The Jane eyeshadow in clay is another one that's coming to my mind because it's very similar to Salted Caramel. Basically what I'm doing with this is, again, since I have hooded eyes, it makes it a little bit easier to minimize the hood of my eyes to make my lids stand out a little bit more, but also too, this is to kind of diffuse the navy shadow before I apply it, because that intensity is quite harsh on a small eye frame like mine. So like I said, go through with whatever warm brown is your favorite. And then this is not a must, but I like to amp up my highlights. So I'm going through with a basic white eyeliner. This is just one from NYX. And I'm basically stamping it into my inner corners to just really make my highlights stand out. If you don't have a small eyeliner pencil, you can go with a white cream shadow base and a small brush. Stamp it into the corners of your eyes. Or if you have the MAC Jumbo Eye Pencil in Milk, that works well too. So all I'm doing is I'm applying it just to my inner corners, and then I'm setting it with the shade Champagne Truffle and another kind of like the e.l.f. C brush, but this one happens to be from Sonia Kashuk because it fits perfectly into my inner corner to stamp on top of that white eyeliner. And then I use it again to finish off highlighting on my brow bone. I really love this color, but again, you're not limited. If you don't use Champagne Truffle, go in with whatever your favorite highlighting shade is from whatever palette that you are working with. This one is kind of more on the pink side, but you can also go more of the champagne, more of the stark white. You aren't limited, so go for whatever your personal favorite is. And then, oh goodness, this was where I wasn't sure how this was gonna work out. Fortunately, it turned out okay, but let's go in with the shade Navy from the Lorac Pro 2 palette. I'm using a fluffy crease brush from the brand Revlon, but you can use your favorite crease brush from your collection. I'm stamping that navy color, oh my, into the outer third of my eye, and I'm blending it up into the Salted Caramel shade. I'm kind of wincing because I wasn't sure what it was going to turn out like, but like I said, so far so good. You have the ability to intensify this if you're going out at night or if you're trying to amp it up for a specific outfit. I want it to be everyday appropriate. This worked really well for me, so I'm just going to go with it. So go on and fill in the other side. And again, if you feel like the edges are a little harsh, you can blend them out, you can intensify the look. But so far, so good. I'm really, really loving this navy shade. And then as we go into liners, you can go a couple of directions with this. You can go with traditional black. You can go with traditional espresso. I really wanted to go with a really strong blue because the navy color has been toned down with the white chocolate and the salted caramel. So it has a little bit of warmth to it. So I decided to go in with the Wet n Wild graphic marker eyeliner in Airliner Blue. It kind of made a little bit of a mess, as you can see, but I really wanted to have a very vibrant royal blue, and then I'm going to go and set it with my Bare Mineral shadow in the shade that I chose for Superman. It's a very intense navy color, so I took the sponge tip applicator of this Revlon Colorstay, oh goodness, Revlon Colorstay eyeliner in the shade Sapphire. I'm using the sponge tip end. I'm tapping it into that blue, knocking off the excess, and I'm going through and setting that Wet n Wild liner. I love how this turned out. It is already looking very summery despite the fact that that navy shadow is crazy dark. So have fun with it. It is a whole lot more interesting to go in and play with some color and see your favorite combinations. Then as I go to my lower lash line, I'm being very, very easy. I want as much brightening effect as I can possibly get. So I'm taking my MAC Studio Chromographic pencil in the shade NC15 NW20. I love how brightening this is, but again, you're not limited. If you have another nude favorite pencil in your collection, go for it. Anything that is going to be brightening is going to be ideal. You could even go in with a white pencil, or if you have a brightening pink pencil, that would work well if you're using something like Champagne Truffle, because again, it kind of anchors everything together. All right, now we're heading into the lower lash line. And again, I really want this look to be anchored down. So I'm going back in with the Revlon Colorstay liner in the shade Sapphire. And I'm actually gonna use the pencil end to just line the outer half of my lower lash line. And then I know there's still a little bit of the blue Bare Minerals pigment, but I'm gonna go through and take the sponge tip applicator end and apply the teal that I chose to pan for Aquaman in the Justice League panning challenge. I thought that the blue and green would pair really well together. It's a beautiful way to set that liner to make sure that it's not going to budge all day or fade. So basically just go in if you have a favorite teal or a favorite kind of navy teal combination. It is an awesome way to really not just anchor the look down, but make it look summer appropriate as well, because again, we're going to tie it down with the blush, the contouring, and the lip color to make it very, very wearable for every day at the moment. So very, very easy to do. Or if you want to go the traditional route and do more of a black liner, or you can go in with purple, you can go in with a brighter blue, you could go in with a green. You have a lot of versatility with this look if you want to go a different direction other than teal. So now that we're going into contouring, I'm keeping it so simple and going in with the shade Semi Sweet from the Too Faced Chocolate Bar palette, because it's so close to the Too Faced Chocolate Soleil bronzer, why not? Let's multitask the palette. If you're looking for a way to kind of space save, if you're on the go, you're traveling, that is an excellent way to make multiple uses out of your palette. So I'm going through with this fluffy Moda brush I picked up at Walmart, and I'm just contouring all of the areas of my face that I want hollowed out. My cheekbones, the sides of my nose, my temples, under my chin, and then just kind of touching up along the sides of my face to really kind of streamline everything. And like I said, eyeshadow is an awesome way. And it really makes it very multi-purpose to take the Too Faced Chocolate Bar, because Semi Sweet is literally like dead on to the Chocolate Soleil bronzer. Then in terms of blush, at first I was a little bit stumped on what to do, because the blush that I've really been using is actually going for this Bare Mineral shadow that I chose to pan for the flash. It's bright, it's kind of intimidating, it's a little red, kind of scary, but it actually works with this look. If you want something that is quite similar, I would go with the Tarte Amazonian Clay Blush in the shade Natural Beauty. It's really pretty strawberry red, a little bit of hint of pink, just like this particular mineral shadow. And the way that I use this, because as you can see, since I depotted it, I went on and I shook the container, because that's honestly the easiest way for me to get enough product in the lid that this is more than enough for me to use for both of my cheeks. So I'm taking my e.l.f. blush brush, I tap it very gently into the lid, tap off the excess, and then blend it on to my cheeks. Just FYI, super easy, inexpensive ways to store your Bare Minerals. They actually have these sets at Hobby Lobby, and they come with a an easy on-the-go travel case to hold them all in. So like I said, just go through, touch up your cheeks with a little bit of the mineral blush, or if you're using like Tarte's Natural Beauty, just put a very gentle flush. The reason I think that this is also so flattering is it does bring some life back into your complexion, because I know navy does kind of, it'll brighten your eyes, but it kind of sallows out your complexion, if that makes any sense. So you want to definitely look like you put a little bit more vibrancy back into your skin. So in addition to using it as a blush, I'm going through with this fluffy, I guess it's a shader brush. It's from Sonia Kashuk, but I'm touching it into the very tiniest little side bit of my Bare Mineral shadow, and I'm very, very lightly dusting it into my crease just to kind of warm it up a smidge, just not a lot, just a smidge. So that way I have a very cohesive look from my eyes down to my cheeks to rosiness in my lips without having to put a whole lot of effort into it. So just FYI, that's another way that you can really anchor your look down if you're trying to pan a blush, or if you have some shadows that are a little too cool toned for you or a little too warm toned, you can always anchor them down with the opposite spectrum of blush, and it works beautifully. And then in terms of highlighting, I'm keeping it simple. I'm going back in with trusty old Champagne Truffle from the Too Faced Chocolate Bar palette. I'm using a Real Techniques contouring brush, and I'm going over the high points of my face. So on the tops of my cheekbones, the bridge of my nose, my Cupid's bow, my chin, and the center of my forehead. Really, really simple. So have a lot of fun with it. Again, if you have a preferred highlighter in your collection, go for it. This just works for me because I'm wanting to multitask these shadows, and I kind of want like a one-stop shop and done situation. So Champagne Truffle is excellent to kind of keep me moving ahead with my progress. Then in terms of lips, Actually, well, go on and apply your mascara, your setting spray, and whatnot. But in terms of lips, I'm keeping it really simple. I have loved, loved, loved this combination for the month. It is my MAC, what is this called in particular? Just MAC lip pencil in the shade Whirl. What I'm doing is I'm outlining the exterior of my lips, and I'm filling in the corners of my lower lip and my upper lip. And then I'm topping it with this Maybelline. Oh, I can't remember what one. Maybelline Color Sensational Lipstick in the shade Warm Me Up. This is the perfect, kind of on the pinkier side nude lip if you're really wanting something every day. You don't have to think about it. You don't need a mirror to apply it. The formula on this is fantastic. There's no weird taste, no weird smell. It's very comfortable on the lips. And like I said, the color on this is just beautiful. It's very, very easy to wear. And then it kind of helps warm... go figure, but it kind of helps make Whirl a little bit more wearable since that lip pencil is kind of brown on its own. So it's flattering, but not necessarily flattering with every single look. But these two together, you can pretty much pair with anything that you could possibly want to wear on your eyes and on your cheeks. So that's it. Have fun with this. Bring in some blue eyeshadow into your life. I know I, for one, am wanting to put a little more excitement into my makeup routine because I've felt stuck in a rut for a little bit, painting a lot of neutral shadows. So I hope that you have as much fun with this look as I have. I am so looking forward to wearing this again and again. It pairs well with navy. You can wear it with tan. You can wear it with gray. You can wear it with black. Very, very versatile. And again, with that teal there, it makes it super summery and very, very wearable to rock on an everyday basis if you're like me and you're wanting to kind of shake things up. So that's about it. Be on the lookout. I do have a couple more get ready with me's using the shade Creme Brulee, kind of more of a plummy vibe, and then definitely kind of a peachy coral pink vibe coming. And then I might do one or two more looks, and then pretty much we're going to be at the end of June, and then it's time to get to work on another shadow out of that chocolate bar palette. So that's it for now. Take care, and I look forward to catching up with you real soon. See ya.